cross is not only teaches us about the horrible nature of sin, like the serpent, but it is much more than that. What is the answer, the permanent answer for man who lives in sin? The cross, come to me. The cross is calling, I thirst. Even on the cross, the voice of Jesus is, I thirst for you, my son. Don't roam around in your sin. Return to God, and only in God you have life. I thirst. Like the snake that was raised up, that has only limited work. Now the Son of Man is raised up, and he gives life to you. Through his blood, your sins will be forgiven. Yes, that is what Jesus is explaining to Nicodemus. And also Jesus tells Nicodemus, not only Jesus will redeem the mankind through the cross. The Son of God will be raised up. Now man who lives on this earth, as Jesus is going to rise above, rise, he defeats sin, Satan and death. Man is going to live on this earth. He can easily forget about the serpent. He can forget about the cross. He can forget about his sin, the consequence of sin. He can also forget the answer that is given to mankind in the person of Jesus and still continue to live. So, God's divine plan is for the man who is redeemed by the blood of Jesus, by the power of resurrection, he is strengthened by the Holy Spirit. So God tells Nicodemus, do you see? Can you see the wind? No. Do you know from where it comes? No. But when it comes, you are tired. When the wind comes, you relax. You see, your whole tiredness goes away. A freshness of life comes to you and you get new energy. Yes, in the same way, though you are redeemed in the blood of Jesus, still when you are attacked by the enemy who will not keep quiet until the breath of God is in you, God is also not keeping quiet. So he gives us the Holy Spirit, and through the Holy Spirit, he will continue to give you the following thing. He says, redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Number one, man needs power to sustain himself, to handle the daily problems with the power and help of God. And that's what done by the Holy Spirit. Number two, man has to face the enemy. The enemy will be continuously attacking. When he wants to go for the job, Satan will tell in the mind, why should you go for the job? You relax, man. You are already tired, man. Why should you work? Your wife is at home enjoying. Why should you go and struggle? All kinds of thoughts by which the enemy is going to ruin you. So you need the power to resist that evil and move on in life. That's what the Holy Spirit gives to us. Third, man has to live the life of God. Not only is it to resist the enemy, he needs to know what is the will of God. Why did he create me? How can I live my life? And this is what the Holy Spirit will teach us. If we hunger for the Holy Spirit, Jesus said in John 14:18, I will not leave you orphan. I will ask the Father, the Comforter, the Counselor, the Teacher, the Holy Spirit to be with you, and he will be in you. If you hunger for him, you should realize that your life is redeemed by the blood of Jesus, and Jesus is risen, and the risen Savior wants to come in and stay in your heart, making your heart his temple in the person of Holy Spirit. Are you prepared? You have to hunger. Jesus said, if anyone who is thirsty, let him come to me. I will come. Yes. So we need to know what is the life of God. And when the Holy Spirit comes, he will teach us. That's what Jesus has promised us. Fourth, we not only to have the life of God, we are also responsibility that where we are living, the world is full of pain. It is the nature that trees don't eat their own mangoes. Mango tree doesn't eat, but still it continues to give mangoes. The clouds, they pour the rain, though they don't quench their thirst by its own rain. Every mother, father, they bore the children and they sacrifice themselves. Sometimes they may not get even the good fruits from the children, but still they suffered. In the same way, you and I who have received the Lord should give life to this lifeless world. We have to become God's witness. You can do many things. Life is full of possibilities. You can have your job, you can have your career, you can have your building up of your talents, your nature, whatever you can do. But all that cannot replace the greatest purpose for which God has called you to be His child. Only the light, with the candle which has the light, can lit the candles without light. You are the one. He trusts you to be His witness wherever you are. I know about a girl called Josephine in the high-tech city. How, though she was to go for the night work as a call center, how, whenever she get time, she used to pray. She used to just close her eyes, read the word, be empowered by the Lord. So many people came along with her. She brought so many souls to the Lord. How? What is her way of preaching the word? Whenever people are in pain, she used to listen to them. And here, the whole world is bothered about themselves. But the child of God has time for others. The child of God is concerned about others. The child of God is willing to die like the master and giving life to others. The human mind will tell you, keep quiet, man. You have got enough and more problem. Finish up your job, run to your home. You have to cook, you have to do this and that. If you hear the voice of God, you will realize how rich you are, how empowered you are. What a great mission God has given to you. And this mission is not a burden. The more you speak about God, the more you give Jesus to God, Jesus to the world, the more you are empowered, the more you are blessed. Your life of witness is the life of your power. And that's what the Holy Spirit does for those who are willing to move with the Holy Spirit. Yes. Romans 11:25 says, the same Holy Spirit who raised up Jesus from death is living in you. So now, Jesus is telling Nicodemus, you have to be born again. Nicodemus is asking, what is this born again? Born again through the Spirit means what? Jesus says, as today's first reading we have heard, number one, we have to come to know who we are. Come to know who are you. What is your mind? Where are you busy with? Where are you going? What are you doing with your life? We read in Luke chapter 15, verse 17. The prodigal son came to his senses. Hello, who am I? Whose son I am? Where I am supposed to be? And I am lying with the pigs. Is it needed for me? Who is my father? I will return to my father. So coming to the sense, this is what we read in the book of Haggai chapter 1 verse 6. The Lord says, you are eating, man, but never satisfied. You are having different type of designed clothes, but still you are not satisfied, clothed properly. You are earning money, but that doesn't give satisfaction to you. For some even doesn't remain with you becomes, there are so many holes in your back. Do you know why? Because without him, without possessing him, whatever you possess on this earth will make you only empty. Only he can stabilize you. That's why in the book of Jude, chapter verse 24, it is written, come to the Lord who can lift you from where you are, and who can stabilize you, and who can lead you, make you to stand before God blameless with a power. Yes. So we have to born again means, number one, we have to come to our sense. Number two, we need to know we have the Savior. So we constantly confess our sin and accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Third, we need to renew our mind. Our mind is the place which the evil attacks. So Romans 12:2 says, read the word of God. Hear the voice of God. Invest your time for the word of God. You have to renew your thoughts, which is trying to be pulled by the world, by the enemy. It has to be stabilized. And then the thoughts have to lead you, move you to higher thinking. As Colossians 3:3 says, so that is done by the word of God. That's why Jesus said, if you remain in me, and my word remains in you, you will bear much fruit. So without committing life for the word of God, we cannot expect the Holy Spirit to renew us or to be born again. So we have to understand very clearly, word of God is the way through which God speaks to us. Word of God is the way through which Jesus came into the world. That's why John 1 says, word of God is Jesus. So if your mind has to be renewed, if your mind has to possess the Lord, there is no other way than the way of word of God. If you don't have time, even for an hour per day, whatever may be the devotion we have, whatever may be the things we like to do for God, will be easily attacked by the enemy. Morning we are happy, evening we are sad. And today, the Lord is teaching us word of God, like we have the food. This is the food of God to renew our mind, to stabilize our life, and to move with God for God's purpose. And all the three things are done only by the word of God. And that is called born again. We come to our sense. We have renewed ourselves with the blood of Jesus. And we feed ourselves and renew our mind with the word of God, and we move with the Holy Spirit, whom God wants to give it to us to be our companion all the days of life. May, as we preparing for the feast of Pentecost, guide us and lead us. Close your eyes. God is calling you. Do you know who you are? Can you see with my eyes? Have you heard what I have spoken about to you? Only the word of God will lead you to the truth and the person of the Holy Spirit. Like Holy Spirit heard the word of God, let there be light. Holy Spirit used the word and renewed life. Word of God is an instrument in the hands of the Holy Spirit to renew the world. Let's commit your life to him. Kneel before the Lord wherever you are and surrender your whole family to the Lord. Ask the Holy Spirit, Lord, help us to know the first stage of who we are. Who am I? Where am I? And where am I lying? And what is the life for which you have called me? If I join with you, what will happen to me? Renew us, Lord.